Thank you for joining us on another episode of the Doubleheader with Mark Shields and Dave Brooks, where we talk about the sport of politics and the politics of sports. So, first on, right now it's tearing up on memorandum, the Sandra Fluke story, which I don't know if you guys are going to talk about downstairs in the big fancy show. But she, for if you don't know, was an individual Georgetown student who appeared in front of congressional Democrats to urge that insurers be required to cover contraceptives. Conservative radio host Rush Limbaugh then branded Fluke a slut who wants to be paid for having sex. Today, President Obama picks up the telephone to voice his support to her. A spokesman said he considers Limbaugh's remarks reprehensible. What's very odd is how large this is getting, how fast. Rick Santorum was asked about this on the campaign trail. He called Rush's comments absurd and said this is Rush, who's an entertainer. Obviously, he's getting more press from us. So,
Yep, Russia's absurd. I mean, if this is not like the newest thing on earth. I remember there were comments about Donovan McNabb a few years ago.
No,
offensive
that's
comments.
Right. Yep.
There have been a whole series of offensive comments.
Yep.
And so this is what he does. I think he sort of means it. You know, this is his business. It's to generate attention, generate controversy. He is an entertainer, generate ratings.
Right.
It serves everybody's interest. It serves Obama's interest to get this hung around Republicans. And so it's sort of a drama we go through. Cynical probably on both sides, but nonetheless, his comments were pretty awful.
The comments were beyond offensive. They really were. And I mean, she was there to testify originally, attempt to testify. You recall it was Darrell Issa's subcommittee, and they'd lined up all male witnesses. I mean, clergy, non-clergy, and it was an incredibly dumb move by the Republicans. I mean, what it did was it allowed the debate to be changed from a debate about religious freedom to contraception. And contraception's a 95-5 issue in this country, whether Rick Santorum accepts it or not. And he doesn't. He believes otherwise. That's fine. But that's the reality. And David's right. I mean, one side says it's a war on religion. The other side says it's a war on women. I mean, it's sort of playing to our most intense and rabid supporters.
Okay, these are the envelopes. Go ahead, check to make sure that they have not been tampered with. There are no hanging chads
They've
here.
They've kept in a Hellman's mayonnaise.
Kept in a Hellman's mayonnaise jar. These were the Oscar polls ballots that we did last week. And if you didn't watch the Oscars, basically it was the artist, and Meryl Streep. Those are the...
Mine is a picture of Angelina Jolie's right leg.
Yep. Oh, but I'm...
I think I'm one for four.
I've got one for four. I got Meryl Streep.
I got Meryl Streep.
I was four for four.
Were you really?
I was one for four. I had the
one
artist.
One for four. All right, so we tied. And then the politics of sport...
Who did win? The John Jacques.
Yeah, right. Yeah,
who was his dialogue coach in that movie?
It was good stuff. We're going to try a silent
It was Marcel
version.
Marceau.
We're going
to
try
if Marcel Marceau was arrested, they say to him, you don't have to... you may remain silent. No, I'm sorry.
We're going to have to try a silent version of the doubleheader and see if we get better ratings on that or not.
That's right.
Today is the anniversary of the 100-point game by Wilt the Stilt. You guys remember that?
I remember it. It was Hershey, Pennsylvania. They used to play in different cities around the country. Obviously, cities that could never support a team full time. But that's where... Wilt, in fact, did get his 100 points. He was an amazing, amazing scorer. I mean, just remarkable.
And it was against the New York Knicks.
It was against
the New York Knicks defense has actually deteriorated since then, so it's the worst thing.
Jeremy Lin did not play that.
No, he didn't. He didn't. A couple things that we wanted to point out, sort of the extra bonus round. Charlie Winham said that today it's Mel Ott's birthday. He was born on this date in 1909, in case you guys remember.
Mel Ott, New York Giants, 511 home runs, I think, and... he's always found in the Sunday New York Times crossword puzzle.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Because
I'm trying to think of a player with a shorter name.
Bobby Orr. there's that Japanese player.
Get it. All right. And then we also have a note on my Facebook wall that says, from Dennis Kinsey, I picked up Mark Shields from the Cleveland Hopkins Airport many, many years ago when he spoke at Kent State University. We had to drive around until we found a place to buy ice cream. He had just quit smoking. Ice cream was his replacement. True or false?
Wow, boy, oh boy.
True or
false? Is
that
Dennis? Dennis said he'd keep that quiet.
Yeah. Mel Ott was in the back seat.
It is so terrifyingly true. I don't remember that particular incident, but I know the generic attraction.
All right, you've wasted a perfectly good 5 minutes. Thank you so much for watching the doubleheader. Mark Shields and David Brooks with me. I'm Ari Srinivasan. Thanks for joining us.